Nick and Brian of the Backstreet Boys, thank you so much for having me backstage here in New Jersey during a concert.
Thank you for joining us.
It's great to see you both.
Thank you for showing up.
You're just raring to get out there on stage right now.
We are, yeah. I mean, the love and the passion that we get from the fans and us doing this for so long, it's, I mean, who wouldn't want to run out there and do what we do? I mean, we're blessed to be able to call that work.
It's interesting, you sit back home. You know, for me, I'm raising three kids, you know, like basically not entertaining anymore. You know, we're just dads back home, you know. Mm-hmm. And, you know, you reflect a lot and you say to yourself, like, you know, why do you do this? You know, what is the meaning of it? You know, and coming back out and seeing, you know, how many people are just so excited, like seeing these people come together. You know, they're out there having a really good time. And I feel like that's what this is all about, is our music, this nostalgic feeling is basically bringing people back together, and we're seeing that in real time, and it's made a whole new meaning for what we do.
Do you still get that adrenaline rush? You like that answer?
Yeah, I do. That's a good answer.
You did well.
You did good.
You've been doing this for a while. Do you each have a favorite song? Like, is there a song that you just go, this is the one I'm here for?
I think about Quit Playing Games.
Quit playing games with my heart.
It was one of our first, like, poster hits, you know, back in the day. It's over 26 years old now, I think. But looking back on that, like, I used to hate to sing that song. But now I think I have a newfound love for it because the people's faces, and they know every word, and it kind of makes them feel like they were 6 or 7 or 8 or 10 years old again. And they're singing, you know, quit playing games with my drink. You know, it's a classic.
You guys have been together for 30 years. Coming up early next year. Mm-hmm. It sounds to me like you've got an appreciation now that perhaps you didn't have in the really crazy times, particularly in the 90s when it was all just nuts.
Well, I mean, it's...
I agree with you.
I
do.
No, there's 30 years of growing. I was 12 when I met them. 12 when I met him, you know?
What was he like as a 12-year-old?
He was too high energy. You know, he bothered me all the time when he was, you know, when he was 12, because he was like, Brian, you know.
Well, that's the job of a 12-year-old, isn't it?
he's like my little brother, you know. I was like literally I was his legal guardian on the road when we would travel, because I was already 18. You know, we were sleeping in hotel rooms together and like just banding together, creating a relationship, a bond that still exists today.
Yeah, the bond that we have as a group is unlike anything or anyone out there. You know, we're basically brothers and a family, and every single one of these guys in this group are, you know, a piece of me, and we're all a piece of each other, I'd like to say. And I think that's kind of coming out in our music and in our performances more than ever now, you know.
True to form, they fight like brothers too.
Today, we were having a little bit of a spat on an email.
Oh yeah,
we were having a spat on an email.
What was it over?
We were just arguing over buses, like.
What? Who's got the biggest tour bus?
It was close.
No, he's just telling the truth. He's telling the honest to God truth.
You know.
And it's a fight. They're not giving up easily.
Your bus is your safe haven, place to go. Uh oh.
Don't believe anything he says.
He's not allowed in this interview.
You can believe everything, man.
Security!
Are you going to crash this interview?
He's going to be security, guys.
Security!
Back up. And Howie and I found out we actually have the best buses on tour. Right? You found that out, right?
All right, so that's part of the blow up as well. What's the biggest blow up you've ever had?
Ooh. Let's throw this at Kevin.
Throw it to Kevin?
Yeah, they're not here.
the biggest blow up was when he, I guess, it wasn't a blow up.
Okay, well, let me ask you.
I would just say when he basically left the band.
I don't think that was the biggest, though. I mean, we just might have a different opinion.
He came to us, like, in a shock, and at the end of the show, and was like, you know, I'm done, guys. You know, I don't want to do this anymore. And that led to us having to go make two albums by ourselves, and we were a foursome for a while there.
How did that feel?
I thought he was joking. I thought he was joking. You know, he was like, guys, you know, it's just not in my heart anymore. I don't want to do this anymore. Not for right now. And we were like, what? You know, I seriously thought he was joking. He's my family. You know, he's the one that got me in this thing, you know? And so it was kind of like a shock. But we pulled together as four and felt like, you know, we're not done. We need to keep doing this because it's a passion and a love. And not one person can take the, you know, take the ship down.
I don't think. Who convinced him to come back?
I think he convinced himself.
Convinced himself.
Very quick quiz, because you guys know each other really well. Who's the boss?
We all are.
Wow.
I would say me.
But... Who has the worst dad jokes?
It's got to be AJ.
No, Howie.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Howie has the worst jokes ever.
Totally.
Who has the best dance moves?
AJ would say he does, but...
I'm pretty good. I was second place on Dance with the Stars against Bindi Irwin from Australia.
You did.
And the only reason she won is because Derek Hough was with her.
Well, guess what? I didn't place on Dancing with the Stars because I wasn't on it. So.
But AJ, my point is AJ had like fifth place or something like that. He came in like fifth.
Okay. So that means you're the best.
Who's saying?
Who spends the longest in front of the mirror?
Kevin.
Wow, that was unanimous. Mm-hmm. Who's the most hopeless romantic?
That's a good question.
I'm going to say you, actually.
You think?
I really did. I think so. I think you're hopeless and romantic.
Wait, I can't do both? I'm either one or the other? I'm hopeless. I like that.
And for info on how you can catch the Backstreet Boys live on their DNA World Tour and to download Lisa's boy band-inspired dance moves, head to our website. Plus, they have just dropped their very first ever Christmas album, A Very Backstreet Christmas, which is out now.